This is Pirates for the original Mac. February 1987, 1988. Microprose Software, Inc. 132.01. That's the star date that it was made. Okay. We'll get right into it. Start a new career. Do you wish to do this historical time period? No thanks. English Buccaneer. No, let's call him Billiam Pack is my name. Apprentice, always go easy, skillet fencing. Young and poor, you seek your fortune in the new world. To purchase passage, you indenture yourself, binding you to work on a sugar plantation for 5 years as payment. But on the plantation, your debts only grow. That voice changed as it went along. You decide to escape this life of debt and slavery. You ask some local seamen about joining the Brethren of the Coast. Aye, mate, they reply. But do you know when the silver train arrives at Santa Marta in 1660? I have no idea. Let's just throw out a guess. Late in the month. The smugglers sneer at your ignorance, but need a strong back to haul cargoes ashore. Eager to escape debt slavery, you join. But alas, your comrades have more surprises in store for you. Oh, yes, you're... The seamen are actually buccaneers. In need of knowledge, they invite you to join their party. But the voyage is unprofitable. The men decide new leadership is required. They nominate you to duel for the captain. Duel for the captain. Where did I get that? Okay, so if you don't win this duel, you might as well start over. Billiam Pacqua is my name. And fencing is my, yes. Okay, this duel should be much easier. Although, so what I've done is, I've looked up online the answer to the question. Seems to be going a bit slower than it was last time, which I guess is for the sake of mercy, because surely it's not suddenly taxing my computer to have to run this 2-bit plane game at 4 gigahertz, I mean 4 megahertz or whatever it was at the time. A Macintosh, a 512K Macintosh, when it was released, would have cost you $95,000 to get it with all the options.
Ah, oh, look at how wonderfully stalwart and bold you are.
Victorious, you and your friends put the malcontents ashore. Now it's time to set course for adventure, fame, and fortune along the fabled Spanish Main.
The sailing master takes you aside. Here in St. Kitts, you'll probably be wanting...
Oh, wait.
Here in St. Kitts, you'll probably be wanting to see the English governor and visit a tavern or two. The men will be anxious for plunder and adventure, so we needn't be sightseeing for too long.
The closest Spanish city was San Juan. The closest French city is blah, 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 blah. The closest Dutch city is... let's go to the tavern.
The tavern keeper listens with interest as you describe it. This is me listening with interest, and my head, which is much too small for my body.
That's why I couldn't... I was thrust into the world of tavern keeping. I really wanted to be a dancer. As my sash will indicate. Look, it's that promising sea dog, Mr. Blackwood. A rowdy group of 29 men asks to join your crew. Do you sign them up? I do sign them up, thank you. In a dark corner of the tavern, a scruffy pirate offers to sell you part of an old treasure map for 500 gold pieces. I'll buy that treasure map, sir. Somewhere near Caracas. We're going to near Caracas for this treasure. Okay, tavern news. England at war with Spain. Indians attack Port Royal. Indians attack Leogon. A malaria strikes Caracas. Holland at war with England. And malaria strikes Margarita. St. Kitts is bustling with activity. What will you do? I'll go in for a letter of marque.
My dear Mr. Pack, we are at war with the Spanish and the Dutch. I charge you to seek out and destroy our enemy's ships and towns. Yes, yes, right, man. Well, off you go, then.
I don't want to bother him again. Let us trade with a merchant. So I'd like to get some food from this guy. And it appears to be expensive. But I can sell nothing, actually, so we'll just get a few foods, as they call them, and we'll leave town. Not having any idea where we're going. Okay, this is a bit of a clunky interface. Sail ho. Let's investigate. It looks like a... Let's investigate still. She's flying Spanish colors. Let us close for battle. And by close, I mean C-L-O-T-H-E-S. The two ships crash together. Through the smoke, you spot the enemy captain approaching. Oh, heavens. Oh, dearest. I always went with a cutlass, because the cutlass, though short, is... it. Every strike you hit is meaningful. And so, this riveting battle sequence begins. Oh. The best version of this was easily the Amiga version. I didn't own it on the Amiga. Actually, I did own it on the Amiga. I just remembered. But what I also owned it on before the Amiga was the Commodore 64. And I remember just looking at the ad for it in the computer magazine and thinking, oh, one day it will be mine. And then I had a birthday, and it was mine. And it was every bit as wonderful and glorious as I had anticipated. Although, from this screen right here, you may not think that. And it was designed, you may or may not know, I'm going to turn the audio down. It was created by the world-renowned Sid Meier. Made later famous for his game Sid Meier's Winkle Bunnies and Toast, and some game about, you know, civilization. I can't remember what it was called. Winkle Bunnies and Toast, though, was where he really made his... Okay, we are wild. We are 69 men.
Captain, we've captured... My first mate's French, by the way. Captain, we've captured the tin... Oh, God. I can't even do that voice without it. It's terrible. I mean, the voice is terrible, yes, but... Okay, we're going to keep this one. And we are going to keep the goods as well.
He strides along with such purpose... In later versions of the game, you can just say, keep everything with one button. Like, why would you, you know, want to keep all, but I guess if you were low on space. And I may play the Commodore 64 version in the future. We have Singlish Waters. Let's investigate. She looks like a bark, Captain. Shall we investigate? She's frying French colors. She's frying French colors. She's frying French colors, Captain. Shall we? Let's piss the French off at us. Even though my first mate is French, I think his loyalty is more toward me. I'm testing my first mate's loyalty by doing this. And 15 cannon, ready for battle, winds a medium. Which ship will you command? I'll command the sloop is nice and fast. Let's command that. Although it has not enough... it doesn't have as much... Oh, come on! I know there's a way for me to raise my sail, to put full sails up and not battle sails, but I don't know what that is. I guess we'll go down here to this lovely, lovely little village down here. Sail ho, we're in French waters. I'm just going to skip it for now. We're going to sail right into the harbor. Okay, they're not angry at us yet. Over a delicious dinner, the governor offers you a French letter of marque, right? Yeah, I'll take it. Okay, so now I can no longer attack the French. The tavern keeper shows you his sash, his lovely sash. Or is that a cummerbund? Or is that some sort of... Oh, it's an apron. It's an apron. The tavern keeper listens with interest as you describe his apron to him because he has the inability to look down for some reason. Look... Is that the promising sea dog? Oh, wait. It's that promising sea dog, Mr. Plack. Pack. A rowdy group of 24 men asks to join your crew. Do you sign them up? Let's sign them up. A traveler from Bermuda offers to sell you information for 60 gold pieces. Do you agree? That's just the look that he's got on his face. I'm a traveler from Bermuda. Oh, yeah. Bermuda is... Wow, that was a waste of money. Thanks. Thanks for that information. I know the population of my hometown. Can I have 30 gold, please? So, how do you... Oh. There's a giant... time machine headed our way. We are from the future. We are from the future where time is told by grains of sand. This here marks the spot where all the ships go missing in the Bermuda Triangle. Please get into it and come to the future with us. And learn about our sand ways, our sandy ways. I guess I'm... that was pause. I see. Oh, that was pause. I was waiting for activity. And I was supposed to be the genesis of that activity. Okay, how do we... I'm pushing buttons randomly. Not randomly. I have a very methodical way of pushing buttons.